Hi guys, my name's Callum Dicks and I'm taking a couple of minutes away from my fishing here at the fabulous Tunnel Barn just to talk you through exactly how to elasticate a pole. Now, elasticating a pole is something I get asked about loads in the shop and whilst I'm out on the bank. You only need 6 components, but I'm just going to talk you through step by step exactly how to do it and how I do it. So first of all, you need your top kit itself, you need your Maver Dacron connectors, whatever elastic choice you're using, your diamond eye threader, some scissors, and a little plastic bead just for the end of the elastic. Right, so first step, your top kit, break it down into 2. It's a lot easier threading the elastic when you've broke it down into 2 rather than keeping it in one piece. The next step, take your elastic out of the packet and put the bead on one end using the diamond eye threader. Simply get your bead, put it onto the diamond eye threader, put your elastic into the diamond eye threader, pull it through, tie a very, very simple overhand knot, use a little bit of saliva to keep it lubricated, and then trim off the ends. That is the most important first step. Now, once that bead is on nice and securely, you're ready to thread the elastic through the top kit. Like I said before, break it down into 2. With the Maver side slots, it's really, really simple. You can just literally put your elastic straight into the side slot and thread it through, down through your number 2 section. Once all the elastic is through, your little rubber bead will sit nice and neatly against the slot. Then your elastic is through. Next step is to put your elastic through your number 1. Very, very simply, just putting it through, making sure you keep some tension on the elastic so that when it reaches the bottom, it will come out at the end. You might have to take your bush out at the very end of the top kit if you find that the elastic won't pass through. Like that, it just didn't quite go through. So just take the bush out, hold on to the elastic, put your bush back onto the elastic. Now the next part of doing it is the most important part for me. A lot of people you'll see out on the bank, they'll have new elastic in their pole. First fish they hook runs off. If they do manage to get it in, what you'll see is a load of drooping elastic out, hanging out the end of the pole. The next step will eliminate that. What I actually do is I get whatever elastic's left out the hanging end of the pole, tie a big loop and I'll pre-stretch it. So this involves wrapping it round something nice and secure. Like today, I'll probably just use a pole that's in the ground, walk the elastic back and totally stretch it out. So I'm actually pre-stretching it so the elastic is bottomed out. Right, so once you've pre-stretched and walked off your elastic, the next step is very important as well, is where to position your Dacron connectors. Now what I do is I'd hold the elastic that's left at the end of your pole and just simply drop the top kit, letting the weight of the top kit tell you where to position your Dacron. So once the top kit is hanging, I pinch that spot there, I take off about another 2 inches just to make sure there's a little bit of tension on the elastic, and that's exactly where I tie a simple overhand knot again. Trim any excess elastic off below that simple overhand knot, and then that, make sure you keep hold of the elastic at this point because it will go back up inside the top kit, and then that's the point where you take your Maver Dacron connectors, simply place the elastic through the Dacron connectors, pull it down and pull the bead on the Dacron connector over the knot, making it really simple and neat. Now what will happen, now that elastic is in the top kit and is tensioned perfect, what should happen when you start fishing with it, even if you hook a great big fish and it bottoms your elastic off and you come back in, it should always return back in your pole, making sure that it's nice and pingy and really easy to use.